Hey everyone, thanks for checking out my YouTube channel, Gone Bad Dog 123. Today we'll be doing this north to Hitchin with this 365 EMU first class capital to connect. So let's get ready to start here. This will be a regular passenger service from King's Cross to Hitchin. Hope my video audio stays put. May have to take my headphone set back here because the cord is messing up on me where I'm losing my sound, so I hope I don't lose it. Yeah, this is a new run for me. I just did a scenario on the last one, so with the same type of unit, so it's got a really good brake on it. Shouldn't be no problem. Got my new Windows 10 up and running. As you see, it looks like there's a whole lot better graphics. The color is a lot more vivid, so I'm pretty pleased with the Windows 10. I can still find everything that I need to use, and I didn't have been hearing people having problems with the games not loading it up right. But what you have to do, make sure you have your desktop icon for your graphics card, because you will have to reinstall your graphics card with the update from whoever or whatever type of graphics card that you have. Mine's got a GTX 660, so mine's by NVIDIA. So I just did an upload or download and reinstalled my graphics card, and everything's back up and running. And this is a career mode in the snow. Today you're scheduled to drive your train from King's Cross to Hitchin, stopping to collect passengers from Powder's Bar, Hatfield, Whalen Garden City, Nebworth, and Stevens. You will then continue your journey to Hitchin, where you drop off your passengers and complete your shift by the end of the day. So start by opening your doors to collect your first passengers. Go ahead and get our lights on. And should be one light over here that we hit. Cab light. And at the center there's dash lights. Get them turned on. And this does not have no wipers really don't help me, because wipers is up too high. So we're not going to use the wipers. At least this is a good long distance. The last one I did like 17 stops. It was 50 something minutes long, and it was none of them that was over. If a very few was over 2 miles in distance between the stops. Yeah, this run here is pretty labor intensive. Like I said earlier in the start of the video, I got a GTX 660 and it's got me pretty well maxed out on the graphics, so I may have to eventually slide it back a little bit. But come tax time, it's not going to know what hit it, because I'm going to switch up to a 960 or 980 with a solid state drive, 500 gig. So that 960 or 980 is a 4 gig video card. So there will be no doubt in my mind that I'm going to have no problems running any of my games. Yeah, once I get out of the city, it does pretty good. Miles to our first stop. Right now I'm running 18 frames a second. Keep getting my fingers messed up since this one does not have the brake control over there. So A is for speed up and D is for slow down. Sometimes I get my fingers going the wrong direction. I do have another program I probably mentioned in some of my other videos. I have some products from Armstrong Powerhouse that does the platform lighting and the lights on the signals. You see them further away and you'll see kind of like a glow from the lights that you see right there. And they go to the regular, like down to the regular color, but you can see them further in the distance. Our first stop will be coming up in under 4 miles. The last train said I had it was 4 cars, so this one's 6 cars. So it might be slowing down. Probably just a little over a half mile away. 26 seconds ahead of schedule. Supposed to be there at 10:20:48. And at our constant rate, we're at 10:20:22. 23 seconds. Should be pretty well much down the platform. There's 4 to 6 cars. Going to full service. Take a look outside. I see somebody got a head cold. He's sneezing. Tail end of the train. Overhead view. There's the inside. Colors look a whole lot better with that DX11 graphics. Next stop would be 3 miles away, or five miles away. downhill. Looking over here on the right hand side for our stopping distance. Since we got more than three or four cars, so I'm assuming it's all the way down at the end. We'll take some of the brakes off. Check our list over here. Got four more stops. Here's down to 2 miles, 2.5 miles. That's going to be a lane change up here at the 30 miles an hour. Can't slide the window or the door here. I think we're going to get up to 115 miles an hour because we have to stop in 4 miles, 4 1/4 miles. So if we do that, what we've been set for 75 miles an hour, then you're going to have to add about another 1/4 mile distance for stopping. Don't want to hit the emergency braking. Yeah, that's gonna kill me right there. There. We have to stop at the next light. Well, it's still yellow, so making a lane change. I don't know what the lane change is going to be. ...70 miles an hour, I guess. Yep, 70. it's a fine line between full service and emergency. We're gonna be late on this one. Them ladies' legs ought to be getting a little bit chilly out there with that snow. This one. We should have one more stop. We have two more. Thank you. Yeah, gonna be almost 2 minutes late on this one. Should have one more stop.
Thank you.
All right, there you have it, folks. The run to Hitchin, somewhere in England here. I'll be uploading the video, so hope everybody's enjoys the video. You can check out my other videos at Gone Bad Dog 123. This is Flight Nut, so leave a comment. And if you like the video, pass it on to your friends there. I'm always doing videos. This is the East Coast Mainline South, King's Cross to Wayland. Hope you guys enjoy it.